We want to find the equation of the tangent line to the curve 4 times the quantity x squared plus y squared to the second equals 50 times the quantity x squared minus y squared at the point 3 comma 1. Well, to find the equation of the tangent line, we'll have to find the slope of the tangent line, which we can find by determining dy dx. And since we have an implicit equation here, we'll have to perform implicit differentiation in order to find dy dx. So the first step is to differentiate both sides of the equation with respect to x. So we'll have the derivative of 4 times the quantity x squared plus y squared to the second with respect to x must equal the derivative of 50 times the quantity x squared minus y squared, again, with respect to x. Now we'll differentiate as we normally would, but if the term contains y, we'll have an extra factor of dy dx because we'll have to apply the chain rule. So looking at the left side, notice how this is a composite function, so we'll have to apply the chain rule, where the inner function would be x squared plus y squared. So if it's helpful, we can let the inner function be equal to u, and therefore we can apply the general power rule given here with the chain rule, thinking of this as 4u to the second. So we would multiply by 2, that would give us 8 times u to the first, where u is x squared plus y squared, times u prime, which is the derivative of the inner function, so we'd have the derivative of x squared plus y squared with respect to x. We'll find this derivative in the next step. And now on the right, we would have 50 times the derivative of x squared with respect to x, that would just be 2x, minus the derivative of y squared, which would be 2y times dy dx. Again, we have a factor of dy dx because this term contains a y, not x. Now we'll find the derivative here. So we have 8 times the quantity x squared plus y squared. We can drop the power of 1 here, times the derivative of x squared with respect to x would be 2x, plus the derivative of y squared with respect to x would be 2y times dy dx. Again, we have a factor of dy dx because this is a y term, not an x term. Let's go and distribute here on the right. So we have 100x minus 100y dy dx. Remember, our ultimate goal is to have all the dy dx terms on one side so that we can factor out dy dx and solve for dy dx. So looking at the left side, let's go ahead and clear these parentheses. We'll have four products here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll have 8 times x squared times 2x, that's 2x to the third, plus the next product would be 2x squared y dy dx, then we have plus 2xy squared, and then we have plus 2y to the third dy dx. On the right side, we still have 100x minus 100y dy dx. Now we'll go and distribute 8. Notice how we have three terms that contain a factor of dy dx here, here, and here. We need to have all of these terms on one side of the equation
and all the other terms on the other side.
So let's continue on the next slide. And now to have all of the dy dx terms on the left side, we'll go ahead and add 100y dy dx on both sides, and then to move these two terms on the right side of the equation, we'll subtract 16x to the third on both sides and subtract 16xy squared on both sides. So we'd still have 16x squared y dy dx plus 16y to the third dy dx, but then we'd have plus 100y dy dx equals 100x minus 16x to the third, and then minus 16xy squared. Now that all the dy dx terms are on the left, we can go ahead and factor out dy dx from each term. So we'd have dy dx times the quantity 16x squared y plus 16y to the third plus 100y. And the right side stays the same. And now to solve for dy dx, we'll divide both sides by this quantity here. So now we have this solved for dy dx, but the right side is going to simplify. Let's go ahead and factor both the numerator and denominator. The greatest common factor in the numerator would be 4x. We'll factor out 4x. We'll also put the terms in descending order. So this would be negative 4x to the second. This would be minus 4y to the second. And then we'd have plus 25. The denominator has the greatest common factor of the denominator is 4y, so we'll factor out 4y. That would leave us with 4x to the second plus 4y squared plus 25. Notice in this form, 4 over 4 simplifies to 1, so dy dx is equal to x times the quantity negative 4x to the second minus 4y to the second plus 25. I guess we could have factored out negative x, but that's okay. Our denominator is y times the quantity 4x to the second plus 4y to the second plus 25. Remember, our ultimate goal here was to find the slope of the tangent line at the given point. So now we'll evaluate this derivative at the point 3, comma 1. So we'll substitute 3 for x and 1 for y. This comes out to negative 45 divided by 65, which simplifies to negative 9/13. So now that we know the slope of the tangent line, and we also know the line passes through the point 3, 1, we can find the equation of the tangent line. We'll go ahead and use the point slope form of a line, which is the form y minus y1 equals m times the quantity x minus x sub 1, where m is the slope, and x sub 1, y sub 1 is the point on the line. So this is x sub 1, and this is y sub 1. So we would have y minus 1 equals negative 9/13 times the quantity x minus 3. Let's go ahead and solve this for y. So now we'll clear the parentheses by distributing here. So we have y minus 1 equals negative 9/13 x. And then we have plus 27/13. And now we'll add 1 to both sides to solve for y. So we'll have y equals negative 9/13 x plus 27/13. And we're adding 1 to both sides, but 1 is the same as 13/13. So finally, we have the equation of our tangent line. We have y equals negative 9/13 x plus, this should be 40/13. Let's take a look at the graph of this. Here's the point of tangency, the point 3, 1, and here's the equation of the tangent line that we just found. I hope you found this helpful.